This video is sponsored by Noragon, the commercial vehicle data experts. Visit noragon.com to learn more.
All right. Oof. That's a red one. That's all right. It's fine. Eesh. Another one. I got this still. Okay. Uh-oh. Oh, no. Here they come. Oh, boy. What do I do? Help! Connected trucks are part blessing, part curse. While it's hugely beneficial to know of an equipment service need as soon as it's required, it's easy to get buried in the notifications. OEMs and technology service providers are doing their part by coding fault codes with red and yellow indicators to help guide your truck service decision-making. But even then, it can be hard to stay on top of. So here are our top tips for parsing through your fault code notifications so that you can manage your trucks effectively. Start with mission critical service codes. You know what that means. That's right. Focus on your engines. Start with the check engine lights. They're a daily reality, and the last thing you want is for a driver to ignore a check engine light and have the truck keep hauling toward a catastrophic unplanned maintenance issue. Beyond that, when dealing with engine fault codes, you want to stay on top of any issues that revolve around coolant level, coolant temperature, oil pressure, and after-treatment related faults from the DOC and DPF sensors. And these are at the top of the list, but you don't have to take my word for it. I just happen to know a couple of the top minds at Noragon. Let's go jump into that video call.
Got a couple questions here as I'm looking at these fault codes. I'm seeing a lot of red and yellow codes on my screen. Alec, can you help me manage these? What are some tips for looking at these red and yellow fault codes and what I do about it?
Absolutely. It's actually a more simple process than you'd expect. What it does is it brings in a very traditional concept of red being your most severe faults, yellow being your medium, you know, not too severe, but not necessarily a green fault. And then finally, your least severe fault, which is going to be your green color. And that way, you can quickly look at your fleet, identify your most critical vehicles, and then prioritize those to bring them into the shop and avoid any potential downtime.
Very cool. Now, I run a lot of different nameplates, got mixed brand fleet here. Lee, are all OEM red and yellow codes made equal? How do I manage a mixed fleet with these fault codes?
Yeah, well, unfortunately, they're not. There's no standard that tells the OEMs that they have to have the same priority level for every fault that you have for another competitor. So basically, you've kind of got to rate each OEM independently. And even within, like, say, for instance, a year range, like an EPA 10 versus an EPA 13 versus an EPA 17, sometimes a fault that's not as severe at one level is now a lot more severe in an EPA 17 application because they've realized that fault means that there is really something bad coming. So they escalate that fault's importance. So you really have to consider them in context. Now your brakes, on the other hand, across your entire fleet, typically within a specific OEM, such as like a Bendix brake, those are gonna be the same across your entire fleet. So you can get a lot more commonality there, but it's still important that you know that you've got different types of ABS systems, all the way from the super intelligent ones that are now being, automated with the automated vehicle systems, all the way down to the basic hydraulic brakes.
Oh, okay. I see. So if I'm looking at like a third party provider dashboard, maybe like the Noragon, is that Okay, I see. So, but if I'm looking at like a third-party dashboard, like Noragon, are you doing the commonality on those fault codes based on my nameplates and helping me on that end, or am I still bouncing around through different OEM dashboards and trying to make sense of it?
No, absolutely. Noragon commonizes. We rate every single OEM's engine model, and we rate every single fault within that engine or brake or transmission. And so we're providing the detail and the action plan and the maintenance strategy that you need to be able to properly address that fault when you see it.
Okay, wow, yeah, so the third-party application there, I can kind of see the power of that. Thank you guys for taking the time to explain that. I feel much better about how I'm gonna tackle these fault codes now.
Absolutely.
Take care.
Excellent insight. So let's help fleet manager me unbury himself, or myself, or whatever. Let's do this. All right, after treatment there, coolant. Tire pressure, brakes, engine, there, that one. Okay, that should do it. Now let's see how this plays out. All right, coolant, not a problem. Ah, after treatment, hate that one, but I got this. All right, this is going way easier. All right. Here's one for you though. How do I get my shop technicians and service providers to actually act on this data? That's a great question, and we'll cover that in our next episode. Thank you for watching. To make sure you don't miss an episode, subscribe to our newsletters at fleetequipmentmag.com/subscribe.